the fate of two of the fastest four-seaters on the planet lies in my hands. I'll start with the CLS, the most refined of the two. First, a warm-up.
So we got a 5.5 litre V8 engine that's got two turbos on it.
Each AMG engine is hand-built, and we're indebted to Herr Errol Conk for his handiwork on this one.
I love the power delivery, it's really addictive.
See, this is the thing, because it can make you into a hero, but it doesn't matter if you've messed up the corner a bit. No. You just plant the throttle, and so long as you've got the steering wheel pretty much straight, boot the throttle, you're going to accelerate down the track. What do you think to the steering?
It's a bit lighter than I expected it to be.
But does it give you confidence?
It does, actually. At no point am I going, this is nearly 1.9 tonnes.
Yeah.
Time for me and the Merc to do our worst. Start the clock.
We could turn the traction off. It's up to you.
I'd say not.
OK. How are you feeling? Are you comfortable?
Yeah, I'm beginning to feel slightly sick.
Well, you did have a sausage roll before you came in. Because of that long wheelbase, it actually makes it quite a safe car to learn to fling around, because when it does go, it's going to give you quite a lot of warning. It's not going to be like a Lotus which spins on a top.
Fair comment.
My stopwatch shows the Merc crosses the line in 1 minute 28.94 with an average lap speed of 75 miles an hour. Can the Panamera GTS beat that? First, I got to know the old girl.
So under the bonnet, we've got a 4.8 litre V8, normally aspirated, so we've got no supercharger, no turbos. Yep. And we've got 424 brake horsepower, which is a massive 125 brake down on the Merc.
Yeah.
But I think the most incredible figures are the torque. This has got 383 pound-foot compared to the Merc's 590. Yeah. That is massive.
It is.
And you can feel that, can't you? Particularly sort of mid-rev range here.
Like now, if I flatten out there, the Merc would have shoved us straight up the back. Yeah. I mean, your hair would have flung right back at it.
But what the Porsche loses on the straights, it makes up for in the corners.
It's holding its haunches down. That big bum is not moving at all.
Which means, in theory, that you should be able to go through a corner with greater speed if you are sort of a Mr. or Mrs. Average.
That's me. Start the clock.
Looks like a duck that's been run over by a JCB or something. It's just awful. It's just so awful.
But it drives like a 911. There's no way on earth you could really feel that you've got two seats behind you in a big boot. So which are you having the most fun with?
It's hard to say. I'm having more fun in corners in this, and I'm having more fun in the AMG on the flatter open sections like this. Go on, give me the verdict.
I will. In which car did you feel the quickest?
The last couple of laps just then in the Pan GTS felt the quickest to me, yeah.
So the fastest you did in the Merc was a 1 minute 28.9. The fastest you've done in this car is a 131 dead.
131?
Yeah.
So what a surprise!
I know.
The Panamera managed an average lap speed of 73 miles per hour, 2 miles per hour slower than the CLS. That means the Merc not only wins this test, but takes the spoils overall. The Porsche is lithe and it's sure-footed, but in the end, can't match the Merc's sheer firepower.